to go, Stan?
Just a second. Gotta go make sure that squirrel I buried is still buried.
Sometimes they come back.
Then it's probably not dead.
That occurred to me, too.
Hold up a minute. Wes is here.
Who?
Wes. The boy from school I like. I felt like we kind of connected on Halloween, when I was drenched in fake blood, but we've barely spoken since then. Does he only like me when I'm drenched in fake blood? Because I'm willing to make that a regular thing.
I knew this day would come. Wednesday. The day you're more interested in boys than your talking dog.
It's Thursday.
I did not see that coming. But it's okay. I'm gonna stay relevant in your life. I can help with boys. What kind of help do you need?
Well, I'm still trying to figure out how to talk to him.
Great. Let's do a little role-playing. You be you and I'll be the boy.
Hey, Avery, sup? You want to go to the lake with me? We'll count the stars and make promises.
Stan, I don't want to do this.
What's your problem? You're so stuck up. I'm out of here. Well, you blew it with that guy.
Look, if you want help, why don't you go over there and see what Wes is saying to his friends?
Okay.
I can't believe I put on deodorant for nothing. You're so weird.
Did I miss it? Should I make popcorn? Did you make popcorn? Why has no one made popcorn?
Avery, as I just got done telling your sister, we are not doing this for your entertainment. Sit here next to me. It's the best view. Have some popcorn.
Okay, Tyler, here we go.
I'll never forget you. Oh, so much body, so much wave. Oh, and I'll miss you most of all, Frizzy Cowlick.
Well, at least this time I wasn't the one being groomed. And man, I've had some pretty crazy haircuts over the years. Cornrows. Pompadour. Princess Leia.
So, what does everybody think?
Well, you can see his face, which is a fact.
Look at me! I'm making hair angels!
I think it looks great, Tyler. I think you're just gonna have to get used to it.
Hand me the mirror.
No!
This is a list of artistic activities that I want to get through on vacation.
Yeah, what's the first thing on your list?
You mean after laminate the list? To finish writing my one-woman show, a dramatic telling of my life, Avery which way but loose.
Finish? You mean you've already started?
Whoa.
I was born!
If only it were that easy. You came out feet first.
Quick rewrite. I was born! And then I learned to stand, and walk, and dance. Then I learned to open the door.
So, Tyler, what do you have planned for vacation?
Something much less creepy than the 4-foot baby. I'm gonna master some tricks on my new BMX bike. By the way, can I have money for a new BMX bike?
Here's a crazy idea. Why don't you get a job and earn the money yourself?
That is a crazy idea.
I'm serious, son. If you get a bike with money you earned, it's gonna mean so much more to you.
But I want it to mean so much more to you.
Your father's right. You're getting a job.
I may have misplayed that one. I'm never asking you for anything again.
Okay.
I may have misplayed that one.
Let's meet Kilgore! Let's meet Kilgore!
All right, but we gotta play it cool.
I'm cool, baby.
Okay, I've got the earpiece in.
Is this costume hiding my mouth and headset?
Yeah, it looks good. Where'd you get that costume anyway?
Oh, I made it with some material I found around the house.
I'm off to my speaking engagement.
Show 'em what you got.
Come on, let's go. Excuse me, are you Kilgore?
Yeah, who are you?
I'm Poodle Lover 152.
Oh, you're a girl. You see, now that name makes sense.
What's that supposed to mean?
But online. Your voice sounds like...
a brawny macho barbarian? Yeah, that's the setting I use on my voice modifier. Hmm. I couldn't choose between that and an Amazon warrior princess.
You made the right choice.
So is it a problem that I'm a girl?
No. Actually, it's kind of cool.
All right, I'm going in for a sniff.
Whoa, control your dog.
I'm sorry, he's just trying to get to know you.
I didn't get a good whiff.
You're scaring him away. Just stand to the side and feed me your questions.
Fine, just do me a solid and sniff his butt. I gots to know.
Finally, I'm going to be a cheerleader. Did that sound like I was living through you? I try so hard not to be one of those parents. We're going to be a cheerleader.
Mom, please tell me this isn't gonna be like gymnastics when you attacked the judges.
You stuck that landing.
Mom.
You're right. I'm not going to live through you just to make up for my past disappointments. I have a perfectly fulfilled life. They're here!
Mom!
I'm doing it again. Take it down or not, Jillian.
Hey, Bree, Maddie. So, I don't really know any cheers, but I do have some gymnastics experience.
Stuck the landing.
If you want to show me some cheers, I can definitely try something out. Okay.
You're in.
Great! It's awesome to be a part of the team. Thank you. I'm in.
You're in.
Heard a noise last night, and we thought it was a burglar.
Oh, no!
That's terrible!
Good thing it was just the computer.
What?
What?
Anyway, it got us thinking, would we be prepared if there really were an unwanted visitor?
Grandma's coming?
No.
Thank goodness.
Anyway, we just need a plan in case there's ever a real intruder.
I was actually thinking, hun, maybe we could get a high-tech security system. I found this real beaut online, the Home Watcher 9000. We can get the whole house wired with sensors and monitors, and they have a remote control.
No. That sounds way too much like that house wizard app you put on our phones. Lights. Lights. Lights!
Simple.
High-tech security system.
You know, the best deterrent to criminals is a dog. And this would be so good for Stan. You know, dogs need a purpose. Working dogs are healthier, happier, and they live longer.
I don't know, sweetie. Stan's not really a guard dog.
But we can train him. You know, he's a really quick learner. Look at some of the things I've already taught him. Stan, sit. Good boy. Speak. Good boy. Shake.
Teach me that?
I don't think so.
All right.
Well, I guess Stan might be a better option than some security system I won't be able to operate.
Sounds like a yes to me.
Yes! That could be my purpose. Guard dog.
Hey, Avery. How's it going? Oh, you working on your painting for the youth art competition?
Yep, and this is the most exciting part of the process. The canvas is blank. All things are possible.
You have no idea what you're gonna paint, do you?
Not a clue. But that's what I love about it. That moment when nothing can turn into everything.
You're totally frustrated, aren't you?
Completely. But I really want to impress the youth art judges. But any moment now, that frustration is gonna turn into inspiration. Then you know what happens? It builds up inside of you until you can't hold it in any longer, and then...
You thart!
They really gotta change that name.
Totally. So what do you get if you win?
I love art for its own sake. I don't care about the cash prize. Only the shallowest, mouth-breathing heathens care about the $200.
Did someone say $200?
It has nothing to do with you. It's about an art competition.
Cool, I'm in. I was just in a stupid art museum for school. One display was just a pile of lasagna on top of a bed. I could do that. I have done that.
Totally missed the point of the piece.
I did not.
The artist was challenging your expectations by commenting on the nature of art itself.
Oh, that's the point? Yeah, I totally missed that.
What's wrong with the birthday girl?
She doesn't like her party.
What? Well, you don't want to miss your 7th birthday. You only turn 7 once. Maybe you should try to enjoy it, because once it's gone, it's...
Once it's gone what?
Once it's gone, you never get it back again. You never get this day back again.
I don't want this day back again.
Quiet, we're on to something else. If I spend all my time worrying about the future, I'll miss everything great about life right now.
That's exactly what I said to you.
No, I'm pretty sure I came up with that on my own. Thing is, before I came to this family, I never got sad like this because I never had so much to lose.
Well, that's the price you pay for having people in your life that you love so much.
Then it's totally worth it. Oh, my one regret is that I didn't lick your toes after you smeared that peanut butter toast on them.
That's not the peanut butter toast I ate, is it?
You said I couldn't stop you.
I don't know what's more disturbing, the fact that I ate it or the fact that I liked it.
Did you guys hear what the theme is for the 8th grade dance?
It's Avery hasn't been asked yet. That's what it is.
No, I think it's under the sea.
I know it's under the sea. The point is, I have no one to go with.
I'm gonna look ridiculous in my mermaid costume without a sailor on my arm.
You know it's not a costume dance.
I am really glad we had this conversation.
I hate dances. I'm waiting for a guy who hates dances too to ask me so we can spend the night going, ugh, I hate dances. And organized sports and musical theater. We have so much in common.
What was I thinking breaking up with Tony right before the dance?
I was thinking I cannot spend another minute with someone who calls hot chocolate hot Chucky.
Pardon me, I couldn't help overhearing because I was eavesdropping, and that's the whole point. I am prepared to escort any one of you to the dance. It matters not which.
I understand you've never asked anyone out before, but have you at least seen it in a movie?
I realize I can be strong coffee. But in an effort to make friends, I have late endeavored to ameliorate that.
And why do you suddenly want to make friends?
Oh, for the same reason everyone does. To have someone say, how terribly droll, when I toss off a Woody Bong Mo.
That's not why most kids want friends.
Well, the masses are wrong again. Quel surprise.
Oh my gosh. What if Carl is the best we could do?
Well, then we'd have to cue some teen movie makeover music and turn that zero to hero. Girls, are you with me? On three. I'm totally kidding. Lindsay, pull your hand back.
Hey, it's Dan. Wake up, boy.
I'm up. You know what they say. The early bird gets the worm. Wait, why do I want worms? I just got rid of them.
Hey, Stan, you want to hear the song we just wrote to wake up Tyler?
It's called Wake Up Tyler. Once we had the title, the rest just flowed.
A 5, 6, 7, 8. Time to wake up, Tyler, make a great start. We know you're in those covers because we heard your morning.
Yeah. Hey, guys.
Shoot her. She wrote the song.
I'm not here for revenge. It's a burrito cannon I made for my job at the food truck. When a person's burrito is ready, I can launch it to them anywhere in the park.
Burrito cannon? Awesome. I'm going long. Hit me.
It's not even loaded. But it's an awesome idea, right?
Yeah, it's just a hot cylinder of meat and cheese rocketing at people at 90 miles an hour. What could go wrong?
I'm gonna ask Mom and Dad to give me the money I need to finish it.
Mom and Dad aren't gonna give you the money for another crazy idea after the pie catapult.
I don't know why Dad was so angry about the pie catapult. He loves pie.
Eating it, not being knocked off his bike by it.